Surucu, Ebru artist living in Chicago. This video is all about the materials that we need for Ebru art, paper marbling art. Soon you will see marbling studio, Ebru art beginner set, and then you will see what's inside this box. I have been practicing this beautiful art form, Ebru art, for 14 years. I had so many students and I love teaching. Teaching part is one of the most fun part for me. So I decided to make step-by-step video series about how to do Ebru art, and I will share my expertise with you, and you will have a complete set of do-it-yourself guide with this video series. If you have any questions, requests or comments, you can reach me from here on comment section, or you can reach me from marblingstudio.com or sevimsurucu.com. While I am talking about little bit of history of Ebru art, I will show my latest marble papers and also artworks to you. Ebru is one of the oldest traditional Turkish art. Ebru is a Ebru and also Ebru, they are Persian words. Ebru means cloudy, Ebru means surface of water. In Turkish we use Ebru name for only this art form. When people discovered paper, they try to dye the paper, right? Paper marbling might have started before the time we know. The general opinion is that marbling has been existing since late 15th century. So this art form started Central Asia, Uzbekistan, Bukhara. It comes to Persia, and then from it goes to from Persia to Anatolia, and then it goes to Europe from Anatolia, which is Turkey. We have the oldest dated examples in Istanbul from 16th century. We can see marbled papers on books, but it might be earlier than these centuries on books, on calligraphy etching. They were used for decorative purposes and also as a background for official documents and signatures. You can copy the papers. So in Istanbul, Ebru art made great development in 17th century. So let me tell you about our great masters. First, Hatip Mehmed Efendi was the inventor of Ebru figures created by drawing concentric circles and then reshaping them with a needle. So Ebru papers containing such figures are called Hatip Ebrusu. Second one, Hezarfen Ethem Efendi was producing Ebru papers. It was one of his many talents actually, which made him famous as an Hezarfen. Hezarfen means owner of thousand craft. So he is the teacher of Necmettin Okyay. Necmettin Okyay also was very influential person in our Ebru history in Istanbul. Before Necmettin Okyay, we had primitive flower Ebrus, but he started a new style in our Ebru history by creating floral designs which are admired by the marblers of the world. Fourth, Mustafa Düzgünman was Necmettin Okyay's premier student and the teacher of many marblers in Turkey today. He is known for codifying the traditional repertoire of Ebru patterns. Mustafa Düzgünman revived Ebru art again. We are very proud of our early Ebru masters that they lead this art from that days to today. Now, Ebru art is not just on the book covers. Ebru art decorates the walls as an art piece with its uniqueness. First of all, Ebru art is a very challenging art form which requires dedication and practice. You are dealing with all the changing materials for creating an art form and searching for the ultimate harmony of the colors. It seems like very easy to sprinkle colors on water and then make one piece of Ebru, but you need to work diligently for getting bright, non-smearing colors with all that changing medium. Each pattern you make is unable to replicate. There's only one chance of getting your work on the paper. You can't make the same work again. This makes the marbled papers unique and beautiful. They are monoprints, one of a kind papers. In this video, I will explain all of the materials that we need for Ebru art. On following videos, I will explain all of the steps one by one with details. Preparation part is very important, so you need to follow all those steps very carefully for achieving good results in Ebru art. So, yeah, we have our marbling studio beginner set here. Let's open this box and let's see what we have inside. Okay. Traditional Ebru art, Turkish paper marbling, different than Western marbling, Western paper marbling art. As you know, we draw figures, flowers on water. We can make marbled papers with so many different kinds of paints, like watercolors, tempera, acrylics, and many other marbling paints, and we can use different materials. Every material behave differently, and the way of performing Ebru art is different. I will explain my way of Ebru art to you with marbling studio materials. If you want to replace any of the materials, it might not work as same as this. So all of the materials should work with each other peacefully, like here. Let's start showing our beautiful materials for Ebru art. Let's start with this powder. This is powder for solution. Carrageenan powder is a fine powder, like seaweed plant from the ocean. It's a food product. You might read carrageenan as an ingredient on the label of some of the products. Carrageenan is the best product for preparing solution for marbling. Even though there are many kinds of gels and thickeners available, nothing has been found that works better for marbling size than carrageenan. This is very fine, very good quality carrageenan. I will make video about how to prepare and tune your solution for marbling, so stay tuned. Second one is ox gall. Is the main material for this art. It goes in the paints and you will use it drop by drop. That's why in the dropper jar. It's bovine animal gall liquid, and it makes the paint float on the surface. Without ox gall, your paint is not gonna spread on the solution. That's why I call this magic potion or power. In my workshop, I am saying that let's add the power to our paints. It gives power to your paint to open on the surface. More ox gall means more power. It means that more drops of ox gall, more spreading. You will discuss about finding balance between paints with adding ox gall. You will hear this in following videos. Now we will go to our professional grade Ebru paints. Paints are water-based paints. They have very good quality and they have very fine pigments. Since they were water-based, they are washable, unlike acrylic paints. Your tray and tools and your brushes, so your space, can be cleaned with water so easily. 2 ounce paint in heavy paste forms, like cream consistency. What is heavy paste? Let me show you, like, this is like very heavy, as you see. And when you dilute your paints with water and ox gall, you will get more than 6 ounces of paints from this jar. The colors used in marbling are obtained from different natural substances such as soils, lahore, indigo, carbon. Like the paints are crushed pigments. Like they are in various colors, as you see, and also they are not affected from sunlight. They are sold as oxide or organic pigments in the powdered form. So also already crushed pigments in the cream consistency. Marbling studio paints, they are prepared by using traditional techniques suitable for every application on paper. The old preparation method is the marbler has to mix the pigments, powder pigments, on a marble slab and then truly crush the pigments with a special shape marble. between two marbles, they were crushing their pigments for like 1 hour, 2 hours with using special technique. Marbling studio paints are already crushed and prepared pigments for marbling. You just need to add water and oxgall to your paints and for tuning. Unlike other marbling paints, you can easily control spreading on the carrageenan solution. You can paint abstract forms, flowers, any design your own. Marbling studio paints are resulting very dense, very opaque, bright colors. As you see on the papers, you can get like very velvety, smooth finish on the paper. Like it retains their brilliance after drying. Still, it's very shiny and then it looks very opaque. So marbling studio paints, they are perfect for both professionals and beginners. I include primary colors here: black, white, blue, green, yellow, and red. So you will get 6 different colors in the set. We will talk about paint mixing and tuning a lot in following videos. Okay, brushes. These are horsehair rose stem brushes. They are traditional brushes. I love these brushes. So we tie horsehair on a rose twig with fishing line, like they do it in 17th century. Western marblers use bunch of plastic straws, but these brushes completely have different characteristics than broom straws. They have distinct splashes, which is so beautiful. I still have my 14 years old brushes. Some of them retired, but I am using most of them. They are very durable, very sturdy brushes. They are prepared with very carefully and then with special technique. The length and thickness have to be proper for perfection in the artwork. It's possible to control the amount of paint you sprinkle by using different brushes. I mean, like we have medium brushes, it has less hair here, and then it splashes different than the bigger brush. And also we have so many different like brush stroke techniques, and then I will explain brush strokes techniques in my following videos to show you different designs with different brush strokes. Okay, these are very cute, beautiful marbling brushes. Okay, now we will go to style set. If you think that carrageenan is my surface, is my like canvas, these are my paint brushes. As you know, we drop our paints and then we shape them, stretch them with these beautiful tools. It comes with 5 different thicknesses. It has solid wood handle, and also the tip is stainless steel. They don't get rusted in the water. Okay, now we will go to another material. This one, alum. Okay, alum is this is 2 ounce aluminum sulfate. Aluminum sulfate is type of a salt. Traditional way, we never use alum for our papers. But when you use alum for your paper, it helps your paints adhere to paper perfectly. That's why I include the alum in the set. That makes Ebru art easier for beginners. We use a sponge dipped in aluminum sulfate diluted with water for aluming our papers. I will explain how to prepare your papers with alum in following videos. And we have water dispenser here. We need to add like, sometimes we need to add like a little bit of water to our paints, and then this is very useful for this purpose. And now this is instruction booklet. Okay, this is, I can say, this is my 14 years of experience in this booklet. I gave all the recipes and some tips for marbling in the booklet. I recommend you to read it over and over again for the beginners for this art. And it has all the tips and all the recipes in the booklet, and then this will help you a lot for marbling. Okay, let's go to our tray. Okay, this is a marbling tray, aluminum tray, 12 by 18, with smooth edges. Smooth edge is important because unlike Western marbling, we scrape our paper against the edge. Scraping means that like we use the paper like this, and then we are taking the paper like that, and we are getting excess solution on the paper while we are dragging our paper. And so I will explain how to get your paints without smearing. I think this is the magical part for Ebru art, getting the colors without smearing them. Your tray should be slightly bigger than your paper, so you don't get too much paint around the paper, too much paint residues around the paper after transferring paints to your paper. Okay, this is our tray. Okay. So paper should be in good quality and acid-free paper. It should be acid-free paper. Using good quality paper is very important. Any polished paper will not absorb the paint, so your paper should be absorbent. You can use any size tray, any size paper for marbling, and also you can use any color, any textured paper you may use for marbling. You will get completely different effect with different colors and textures. You can purchase like economic or professional grade white, ivory, black colors Ebru papers from marblingstudio.com. This is same like 12 by 18 papers, and you will get 100 12 by 18 papers in this set. Okay, now we will go to our jars. We have I include like three jars for your paints, and also three small jars. Small jars for Ebru flower paints. We call it like flowers jars, and also I call this one like working jars because you are gonna use them by your tray. And then I'm actually naming the jars because we are gonna use many jars, and then you will see in following videos. So because I am giving all the recipes with this amount of paints, and then that's why you need to use these jars. So as you see, all the brushes goes in the jars. Those are these are small jars for small brushes, goes in these jars. And then they will be our flower paints. Okay, now this is the set for like without comb set, but you can purchase your set with combs. It comes with two different comb, and the long one goes like that. And the long one also goes like that too, because there is a like wider gap between two needles. And also we have 12 inch comb like this. Okay, and then it goes the short way like that. And then if you get your beginner set with combs, you are gonna have two combs for you. And newsprint, so I didn't include newsprint for the beginner set. Actually, you can. We use newsprint because like newsprint breaks the surface tension before painting, and also it clears the residues from previous painting. I didn't include newsprint, so you can use any newspaper, old newspaper, or you can buy thousands of newsprint like me for marbling. And so Western marblers usually use strip of paper for cleaning the water, and I find this method is more easier. So I clean the surface at once with single paper like that. And but you can use like strips of papers for cleaning the surface. Okay. I am done with showing all the materials in the box, and thank you for watching Marbling Studio Ebru Art Beginner Set Unboxing. Marbling art is such a lovely art technique you can learn as a hobby or as a profession. As you see, it includes everything you need for Ebru art, all of them in top quality materials that I personally use for marbling. Now they are available for you. Please check my website marblingstudio.com for purchasing this beautiful set. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, and also subscribe to my website to get notified about my following step-by-step do-it-yourself Ebru art videos.